Lighting is one of the coolest visual effects that you can have in any general video game. As of right now, we don't have native support for lighting. Yet. It's a planned feature, so hang on. But for those who want lighting now, or who are just impatient, there's ways to mimic good-looking lighting in hyperPad.
Okay, seriously, what the freak?
It's the spooky movie.
Yo, what the freak?
Yo, he's creeping me out. Yes, there's ways to mimic good-looking lighting in hyperPad. We just have to improvise. We've already got all we need to make this cool feature. I will show you the easy way and the hard way. Both of these methods have their own strengths and weaknesses, so use whichever one fits your project, or use both. Okay, for those in a hurry or something, the easy way is grabbing a white radial gradient asset, putting it in a dark looking area, and stab it to death. And applying the dodge blending mode on it. You can adjust its color and transparency from there. You can apply blending modes on a selected object by selecting this icon and pressing whichever mode you want. What the blending mode does is change how your object will be rendered over other objects so it looks different. And that is literally it. Also, you can do this to any other sprite and not just this one. I use the radial gradient because it's very versatile. It fits in almost any scene, but you can use different images and get different results. Oh, and the image. I'll be sure to provide the download of it in the description or in the comments. You can also search for it online. It's a white radial gradient. Just make sure it has a transparent background.
Not a hard way.
In my opinion, it just looks better and it functions just like actual lighting. You cannot see things in complete darkness, but light sources can be used to reveal dark areas, just like in real life. The way this works is that there's a big graphic object that follows the player. The graphic of this object dynamically updates a couple times a second. It's just a black background with some transparent spots in it. These transparent spots represent the light sources, and those spots would move depending on where the light sources are relative to the black box. I recommend doing this on a new layer, just to make it easier for yourself. Of course, you can put this wherever you want, it just needs to overlap the objects that you want to be affected by the lighting. Now, to make this, place down a graphic object. You can use any sprite you want, it will be the placeholder for now. You can simply drag an image out of the assets. This wouldn't work on empty objects or any other object type. Inside it, we want to create the black canvas that we saw earlier. We would use the render texture behavior to do this. You can set its width, height, color, and we can even apply effects and filters on it, but I'll leave that to you guys to experiment. Oh, and don't worry about this part. This is just an input render texture behavior, just in case you want to apply multiple effects on top of each other, but I won't be doing that. I recommend using a canvas size that is larger than the screen. I'd say around 32 by 32 meters would work. Now, if we playtest, we don't see a black canvas. We see this placeholder image, so nothing changed. So, we go back and use the set graphic behavior after the render texture. That way, we can see what the render texture is outputting.
You better not be hiding any secrets from me.
You should set the scale to 100% by 100%, so the canvas is the correct size. This means that 1 meter on the canvas will be equal length as 1 meter on the world, which makes it easy for us. Also, we need to make sure that the anchor of the object is 0, 0, because that's where the origin of the canvas is. That means if you draw a light source at 0, 0, it will draw on the bottom left corner. This will make it more convenient for us when we go on to programming our thing.
Our very thing. Yes, our very thing.
Okay, now he's being creepy.
He's definitely in the Halloween spirit. Oh my god. Now we test it, and now we see a black screen. Yay! Yeah, that was what it was supposed to do. We want to put white radial gradients or circles over this black background. And you're probably wondering, why the color white? Are you freaking racist? Just kidding, I love you. Wait, that doesn't even make sense. Anyways, yeah. Because it is bright compared to black, and we will use the burn blending mode so that the bright areas become transparent. That's how you get those parts that are see-through in this black canvas. there's going to be a timer that constantly updates the canvas, so I'll do something like this. And in the render texture behavior, make sure that it is resetting every time. If you don't toggle this on, it will ruin the effect. And I'm going to use a behavior bundle. This just ensures that the behaviors are executed in the right order, which is from left to right. So very first thing, the canvas should reset. So I'll put it on the left. Now, we get the position of the canvas object. Then, we want to loop through each of the light sources in the scene. But before we do that, we need to set up our light sources. Duh. In my scene, I will select the objects to be the light source. Oh, and it can be a moving one too. Add a tag to the objects. You can name them whatever. I'll call them daddy. Light source. Oh yeah, I guess the player could be considered a light source, because how are we going to be able to see our character? I mean, that's optional. I know some of you guys would want to do it on your project, so yeah. Well, in this example, I guess I might as well just put the player as a light source. Now, back to the behaviors, we want to loop through each of the light sources. Select the tag that you used. Then get the position of the light source. You can either use the tag or the current value from the loop behavior. They do the same thing. Now we want to subtract the X and the Y positions from the light source by the X and Y position of the canvas. If you get the order wrong and the light sources are not where they are, simply swap these inputs. The light source position should be at the top and the canvas object position should be at the bottom. All this is doing now is getting the relative position from the canvas to the light source, so we can use these values to draw the white radial gradient in the correct position. Let's grab a draw behavior. This is where we get to render in our light sources. We want to draw in the white gradient sprite that we have, so we wanted to draw an image. Take the results of the subtract values behaviors and plug them in to the corresponding inputs. We get to decide how big the drawn image will be, so I'll set it to around 5x5 meters. We can adjust from there if it's too big or too small. Oh yeah, we should put the set graphic at the end so we can see the result.
Let's test this bad boy.
Well, now we just have to make it follow the player. So in the behaviors, we can have it move to our player. Use 0 second duration. Oh, remember that 0, 0 anchor that we put on the black box? This means that the bottom left corner of the object will move to the player, which we don't want. So to adjust for that, in the move to object behavior, we can set these anchors back. So let's set it to 50-50. Now, when this behavior executes, the middle of this canvas object will move to the middle of the player object. And that should be good. We have our cool little lighting system. You can actually combine this with the other method to create for some great looking scenes. You can use attributes to define custom parameters of the lighting if you want. So each object can emit a certain amount of light. Now, attributes can be quite confusing, so let me know if you want a tutorial on that. But yeah, that's it for lighting.
Man, lighting is so cool. I love it.
Now, the easy way of doing this is putting a white radial gradient in that dark looking area and stabbing it to death. Oh yeah, don't forget to fart on it.
Hey, what?
This guy confuses me.
That will be all for this video. If you want to see more content like this, please consider following our Instagram and subscribing to our YouTube channel. Comment what you would like to see next, and you could be selected for the next video. See you later.